Let's have a little bit more fun with operators. We'll start by using just literals to demonstrate, but these operators work with variables, constants, and if you're accessing struct property values like we've seen so far. First, let's add two numbers together. And as you expect, 5 plus 3 is 8. We can subtract two numbers. And notice if we use subtraction between these two numbers, 5 and 2.5, where 1 is a floating point number, we get a floating point result. And that's because the Swift compiler is smart enough to know the difference between subtracting two integers here and getting an integer result, and subtracting out a floating point value here to compute a floating point result. We'll go ahead and do the same for multiplication and division. But here's something that's a little bit interesting. How come when we divide 5 by 3, we just get the value of 1? Well, since the Swift compiler knows both of these literal values are integers, when it performs the division, it does not include the decimal part. Instead, it truncates the decimal part and leaves you with this whole value of 1. Now let's see what happens with the dreaded divide by 0 case. It looks like the Swift compiler is smart enough to know that this is a divide by 0 and it can't execute this. But enough with these literals, let's try some actual variables now. I created these ahead of time, so I'm just going to paste them in. And we have a variable for the value 5, 3, and 0. And now we're trying to do the same 5 divided by 0 or a divide by 0 case, but what's going on this time? Last time the Swift compiler was able to detect the divide by 0. Well, this time, since we're using a variable, the Swift compiler cannot automatically detect the issue. Instead, the playground file tries to run this code, and as you can see, the execution is interrupted because it can't execute this. And we can tell that the execution of the playground stopped because if I try to go a line below and do anything, we can see that it never reaches this line. It stops right here. So let's just remove this and comment this line out. There's one more operator I want to introduce which belongs with add, subtract, multiply, and divide. And that's the remainder operator, also called the modulus operator. Many times you'll hear it called mod for short. The mod operator allows us to perform division and then return only the remainder. And this operator is really useful when determining multiples or if a number is even or odd. By the way, the modulus operator is the percent sign. And we can see if we mod 10 by the number 2, the remainder is 0, so we know that 10 is an even number. Let's try this with an odd number. And in this case, because the result is 1, we know that the number is odd. But you don't just have to do even and odd. Let's try an example for, say, multiples of 5. We know that 5 is a multiple of 5, but 6, 7, and 8 are not, and we can see the remainder is here.